I'm actually trying to be an actor, entertainer in the Philippines. So I was just wondering what, I'm actually going to audition for Pinoy Big Brother on Saturday. So I just wanted to know what your best piece of advice for someone like me to try to break into the industry over there is, would be.
Great. So this question can just not relate to entertainment, but you know, for everybody that is outside of the entertainment world.
Me? Okay, so when you're at the Pinoy Big Brother's house, if you look up on the seventh floor, that was my office right there, the window right there. I used to look down on that house and be like, dang, children. Like, how are you doing in there? Oh, wow. Best piece of advice for making it in the Philippines. And this goes for anything, entertainment and otherwise. Know who you are before you jump into the mix, because it's going to be so easy to want to adjust with every little bit of input that you get. Be like, oh, you should do more of this, or you should be more that. And it is so easily possible that you will get swayed and lose sight of yourself. So before you jump in there, know what you want to achieve. Know who you are. Secure your voice so that it doesn't waver later on. Don't just fall for anything, I guess, I would say, yeah. And same thing, network, the Philippines, the entertainment industry there, it's a very tight-knit community. Again, some things that I've picked up from past TFCU talks, be it Rosalyn or whoever was talking, it's really the relationships that you build. So bank on that. And your good looks and your talent.
Is this your first time there, or?
No, I actually travel to the Philippines every year since 2005. I was baptized there, confirmed there, and I actually speak Ilonggo, so.
Ilonggo? Oh my God, okay.
Tagabakolod ako.
Ah, okay, great. We'll talk after this. Well, I guess I wouldn't tell you how it is over there because you go frequently enough, but in the industry, you'll be bombarded with too much information. So you should have the ability to screen them. And humility comes a long way. Okay, the pakisama, of course, with the right people. You know what you're not supposed to do and what you're supposed to do. Do you have a manager yet?
So I'm linking up with a director, an indie director that my mom's soon.
Okay, right. We'll talk later.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. My only piece of advice is if you're going to do reality TV, just know how to throw a ton of shade. And
I'm pretty good at that. I can do that.
Throw a ton of shade and then just be soundbite master. Just be like, yes. Yo. If you can cut like a 5-10 second promo, you know, ugh, gold.
That's true. I can do that. All right. Thank you.
Norman, go ahead and answer that if you feel called.
I was just going to say, set your expectations properly because reality TV, as Rich kind of just conveyed, you know, that's why you want the hits, but understand that what's coming out of that is not going to be, you know, Oscar-level performance.
Sorry, I have to inject this. The shelf life in the Philippines for newbies is 6 months, just so you know. So I just realized that every 6 months there's new artists, there's new everything. So you have to identify yourself as to, again, what you want to do, what's your purpose of going there, and where you want to take your career.